Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video I'm going to show you how to use styles in Affinity Designer. Styles are a great way to use the same attributes over and over again with just a click. Here in our styles panel, you can see the pre-installed ones that came with Affinity Designer. And if we just click around a bit, you can see how easily we can add these various styles to text or shape. We can even come in and manipulate the style further by coming under Effects. You can change the opacity. So we have full control over the styles after we've created them by simply coming back into Effects and changing whatever effects we may have added and saved to that style. But it makes it very convenient for setting up a particular style and being able to use it over and over again with just a click. Now, let's take a closer look at our styles panel. Over here on the right side, this drop-down menu will give you various options. We can add a styles category, remove a category, rename. We can also import styles and export styles categories as well. And once we have a style that we have selected, we can also add that to our category. So we'll come up here and add styles category, unnamed to. I will now come back up here and click rename category, and we'll name this tutorial. Now that we have a new styles category, we could create our first style. We'll start by creating a style for this shape, and then we'll be able to apply it to the text. I'm going to go ahead and create a metal effect, and I'm going to start by adding a simple gradient. I'm going to come up here to our gradient options. Adding some additional points to add various shine effects. This is a dark metal, so it would be something maybe more like steel. And we can come in here and continue to manipulate this gradient just a little bit. So once we like the metal effect that we've set up, with the object selected, we come over to Styles, our drop-down menu here, and Add Style from Selection. We can then rename the style by right-clicking on it, rename style, and we'll call this steel. Now if we come up here and click styles, and come down here and click on the steel style we just created, it'll automatically transfer that gradient to the text. We could do the same here for the ball, and we can also change the, by selecting the gradient tool, from a linear gradient to a radial gradient. We can move this around here a little bit. We can add some depth and dimension to this circle that we have as well, now creating more of a sphere that would be representative of that steel metal effect that we created using the styles panel here. I have gone ahead and created various styles here, which will be available to download for free in the description below. I've included some precious metals, gold, silver, copper, as well as some gemstones. Jade, sapphire, and ruby. We've also got a few extra for fun. We have some lighting effects for spheres, some various effects that have a little more of a three-dimensional feel to them, and this fun sunshine kind of text effect up here as well. Styles can be made using gradients and any of the effects in our effects panel here, and they can always be manipulated after the fact as well. Styles can be a very powerful tool for vector illustration, allowing us to create a set of attributes once that we can then use over and over again with just a click of a button. You can download these styles for free by clicking the link in the description below. You can also support the channel by donating. It helps me continue to create new tutorials and bring you new vector assets. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comments below how you like to use styles in your work. Keep chasing your dreams. Until next time.